With Dale McTavish of the Pembroke Lumber Kings. Actually, Pembroke Lumber Kings, here we are on February 9th, making their first visit to the Brockville Memorial Center. Weather playing a little bit in that. But Dale, for the Lumber Kings, obviously sudden change was in the mix in the off season. Sean Crozier out. You're back at the fold, back in the middle, in the thick of things. Just maybe describe the changes there.
Yeah, I think just coming off last season, you know, we didn't have a good season, and obviously I take, you know, a lot of the blame for that. But I just felt we needed to, you know, after finishing where we did, I think we had to make a change. And, you know, I have a ton of respect for Sean and the job he did, but I just felt it was, you know, we had to make a change, and I had to come in and go behind the bench and try to turn it around.
Lumber Kings as well, trying to address at home at the PMC, add a little bit more fan experience. You made some changes there.
Yeah, we're trying different things. You know, we tried a VIP section. We've since changed it back to how it was, and just trying to get more fans. We have some stuff for kids in the rink to try to make it more of an enjoyable atmosphere away from the game, also just to, you know, attract new fans and younger fans, and trying different things, and some things will work and we'll keep them, and some things won't, and we will change them. So it's trying to new things, and hopefully things work and people like coming to the PMC to watch games.
The Kings again, as far as the playoffs go, on the outside looking in last season, you're right around, you're still in the mix right now. Actually, you guys have been a little hotter. You won 6 out of the last 10.
Yeah, I think we've been, you know, up and down. I thought we started out really well. We had a really bad stretch we lost 8 in a row just before Christmas. That really, you know, put us back in the standings. But we're in 7th right now, and, you know, we have some games in hand. If we win the games in hand, we can, I think, move up. But obviously we want to get in the playoffs and do as well as we can. Kind of a, you know, a bounce back year from last year. And, you know, we have 15 games left. We want to win as many as we can to try to move up and make some noise in the playoffs.
Goals against and penalty killing are two areas that kind of maybe have been the Achilles heel.
Yeah, the goals against, it's a frustrating one because we work on it a ton, and it just for, you know, mental breakdowns or individual mistakes sometimes, but we're working on it, and the penalty kill also has really let us down at times this year. You know, and the power play at the start was really good, and then it's kind of gone cold. So those are things that special teams and defensive play that we're working on, and we know we're going to have to be good at that to move forward and to win in the playoffs. So it's something that we're addressing and working on every day.
Dale, this is game 3 in the 6-game series. I guess the Braves and Kings are going to get to know each other quite a bit here in the upcoming time. You'll be back here 2 more times. Like, actually, I think back-to-back nights, March 6th and 7th, and the Braves have to head back to Pembroke. 2 previous games, you beat the Braves 4-1, and then the Braves, which doesn't happen very much in Brave history, 6-2 victory at the PMC is strange, but 1-1 in the season series. What's your thoughts on those 2 first games of the Brockville Braves? What did you see in that?
Yeah, I thought the first game we played really well. I don't think we gave them a whole lot. The second game, I thought they really improved, and they really worked hard, outworked us, I thought, for that game, and outcompeted us, and we really they really put it to us in Pembroke that game. So I'm expecting a team that's going to work hard and really be, you know, defensively responsible. So we're going to have to really bring it. They've made some changes, brought in some good players, so it's going to be a tough test for us. And you know, with 4 games against them, we're going to have to, you know, obviously win some of those to move up. And you know, I'm looking forward to see how we do and how we compare against these guys tonight.
Yeah, looking at your schedule recently in that 6-10, I think you just lost to Ottawa and Carleton plays one little boo-boo, I guess, in Kempville, but then no easy games in the CCHL. The Braves fell to Kempville here on home ice a few weeks ago. So you've got 3 with the Braves, 2 with Smith Falls, a couple with Kanata. It's nothing too much with the 2 big teams.
Yeah, I think we have 1 game left against Ottawa, and then we don't play Hawkesbury the rest of the year. So it's, they're all tough games, like you said. I mean, it's, you know, we have to show up and be ready to play. And I think we've learned, you know, we've had a few lessons this year where, you know, it doesn't matter who you're playing. If you don't respect them and don't play hard, you're not going to win. So hopefully we got that out of the system. And, you know, we look for every game is a tough game, and we have to bring our best to win.
What do the Kings need to do to be successful tonight?
Well, I think, like you said before, penalty killing has to be good. Our special teams, when we're good on our special teams, we have success. And defensively, we have to make sure we get the puck out of the end and get the puck deep on in Brockville and play in their zone. Really transition quickly the puck and really forecheck hard. I think those are the keys for us. So that's what we're looking to do tonight.
Thanks, Dale. Good luck tonight.
Okay. Thank you.
Dale McTavish of the Pembroke Lumber Kings.